Frederick Douglass and Henry Highland Garnet, both fugitive slaves from Maryland, led opposing camps on the question of whether violent slave uprisings were necessary in advancing the abolitionist cause.
Douglass takes the position that you have to fight it within the American constitutional system. Garnet holds the view that you must strike a blow, violence must be used.
Garnet, a Presbyterian minister, delivered what was later known as the Call to Rebellion.
It is your solemn and imperative duty to use every means, both moral, intellectual, and physical, that promise success. The pharaohs are on both sides of the blood-red waters. Brethren, arise, arise! Strike for your lives and liberties. Rather die free men than live to be slaves.
Henry Highland Garnet challenges the use of the story, because Exodus offers, right, hope. Pharaoh drowns in the Red Sea. There's a wandering in the wilderness, but one enters the promised land. What Garnet says is Pharaoh is on both sides of the blood-red waters. And that's an attempt to interrupt an interpretation of the story that is awaiting God's intervention. We can't wait to get on the other side for freedom, because there's no other side.
Douglass, with a mix of conviction and political pragmatism that would make him the most influential black leader of the century, surmised that Garnett's suggestions would antagonize northern black allies, ultimately bringing harm to the abolition movement. When the convention finally voted on whether to publish Garnett's address, Garnett lost, but only by one vote. Soon, Congress would appease the South by passing the Fugitive Slave Act in 1850, which strengthened the provision in the Constitution that escaped slaves must be returned to their owners. The Civil War loomed on the horizon. Douglass became reconciled to the fact that slavery must end violently.
Action, not criticism, is the plain duty of this hour. I now, for the first time during this war, feel at liberty to call and counsel you to arms.
On April 12, 1861, defenders of slavery in South Carolina cheered as Confederate guns opened fire on federal troops stationed at Fort Sumter. The Civil War had begun.
The African American experience had always been one that they were looking to prophecies for freedom, and of course the Civil War was the fulfillment of that prophecy.
There was no longer a question of if, but when violence would erupt and bring an end to black enslavement after so many generations of unrelenting suffering. The apocalypse at hand, black Christians believed that the fall of Pharaoh and their exodus from Egypt finally was at hand.